Are you feeling better about the response
feeling much better
by the feds?
I had an occasion yesterday when I left your office after the interview. There was a conference call between me and the Andrew Cuomo and the President of the United States. We laid it all out, and we were promised all types of commitments for today, and they're coming true.
So you talked to the governor, you talked to the president?
Yes, yesterday. As soon as I left your office, my phone went off, and it was the governor trying to reach me to say he was putting together a conference call, and I waited.
And Secretary Napolitano came today.
She came in today. I met her at the airport. Nice conversation with her on the way to the middle field, and things are looking up. I mean, we have all kinds of... In fact, I have a whole team of FEMA people, deputy, sleeping in my office. Mm. I got cots there. I got a whole team. He said, that's your disposal, Mr. President. You do whatever you got to do.
You know, I feel bad that I wasn't in, that we weren't here sooner because, you know, we were so focused on New Jersey and Queens and all the other places. But you come here, and I mean, my God, it's unbelievable.
Then you know my frustration.
Yeah.
The frustration that I had when I didn't have no help, no support. What it was doing to me. It was killing me. So I spoke out, you know, get angry.
And that's what it took. It made a difference.
Right.
And that's, I mean, it's frustrating that it took you yelling yesterday morning to start to get people to pay attention. But thank God you did.
Pay attention, right. I mean, you see the damage he had done.
Yeah. What do you make, you know, you walk around here and there was like a motorcycle group here handing out food. There's a blind woman here on the street with her dog handing out food to people.
No surprise to me. I tell you why. I know the population. I know the people. We were down in Miller Field, and there's this young lady with her son as volunteers giving out food. So I went over to her. I said, did you have any destruction or any harm to your house? She said, well, not really. She said, the tree did fall down and crushed my car. I said, but that's all right. I said, you here as a volunteer? She said, of course, she said. These people need the help.
Yeah.
That's the people you have to stand now.
Yeah.
That's the people you have to stand now.
My family goes back hundreds of years on this island.
I know that.
And to see it like this is it's just stunning.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But we're getting a lot of support now. We have Red Cross trucks going up and down through the community, telling people that we have food. And tomorrow I'm going to look at the two warehouses where I get food. The Yankees just called me. They're going to send me down loaded jackets and
I've had people stop me on the streets in New York today. Yeah. I was walking along and saying, how can we help Staten Island? What can we do? So what do you tell people?
We started a foundation this morning, believe me, through the Silla Foundation, which is run through the tower run.
Uh-huh.
He does once a year. This morning, up to now, I raised almost $500,000.
$500,000
already.
And how can people contact that? You know?
Well, it's the Silla Foundation.
Silla Foundation.
You know,
okay, and we'll get the website. We'll put it on our website.
Yes, the website. I really appreciate that.
Okay.
And that's what we're going to start using that to pump our basements and get companies.
I'm hoping this stuff that's been secured for the race is going to get distributed. I mean, I saw like 100 porta potties just at the start of the race. Can that stuff get distributed to people here?
Well, some people, we could use it some places. We could use it some places. So I was speaking to Speaker Quinn today just on that subject matter.
Okay. All right. We'll continue to stay in touch. Appreciate it.
Thank you. And thank you for what you do.
It's a little late.